Also, the father of Ayla Reynolds says he hopes to tell whoever has his daughter that they had no right to take her.
Well, the investigation into the disappearance of the toddler from Waterville began on December 17th when her father, Justin DiPietro, reported her missing. Yesterday, he spoke in public about Ayla for the very first time. News 8's Dave Guthro is live this morning in Waterville with the details. Good morning, Dave.
Well, good morning, Aaron. Good morning, Shannon. That's right. In his first on-camera interview since the disappearance of his daughter, Ayla Reynolds' father, Justin DiPietro, said on a national morning show yesterday that he's willing to do anything he can to ensure the safe return of his daughter. Now, he also spoke to us yesterday off camera later in the day. He told us the story of his missing daughter has already become a media circus, and he doesn't want to contribute to it. He said that he gave one TV interview to plead for his daughter's safe return and that it served its purpose. DiPietro also reiterated that he saw Ayla for the last time when he put her to bed on December 16th, and the next morning she was gone. Now, initially, this was a missing persons case. The Maine State Police is now leading the investigation. They believe foul play could be involved. Meanwhile, Ayla's grandfather, Ron Reynolds, the father of Ayla's mother, Trista Reynolds, reacted to Justin DiPietro's nationally televised interview yesterday. Even though DiPietro pleaded for his daughter's return, Ron Reynolds, who has been very vocal since the disappearance of his granddaughter, says there are still more questions than answers.
How can you not be out there in the public's eye? How can you not want the media to have contact with you to get the word out there? You can't tell me as a father you don't know. You don't know where your child is? Are you kidding me? No, I'm not buying it. And I don't care what he says. I don't care what he says. And I tell him right to his face right now.
Well, Reynolds also told News 8 yesterday he still believes Ayla is alive and continues to plead for her return. Again, the Maine State Police now leading the investigation. The investigation is ongoing, and we'll have the latest details and information as it becomes available on our website, WMTW.com, and, of course, right here on News 8. For now, live in Waterville, I'm Dave Guthro, News 8.